Hi, I'm Shannon from ETSU eLearning, and I'm going to show you how to view your live streaming class with your web browser and Cisco WebEx. Let's get started. First thing we're going to need to do is open our Desire to Learn page. Right now we're looking at the ETSU homepage. You can find your link to D2L up here at the top, and that will take you to your login. You can also just type elearn.etsu.edu. It'll take you here. Log in with your credentials, and that will take us to our class page. Now, this page is generated for every class. For live streaming classes, you're going to see these boxes. They're a little bit different. Spring 2015 streaming, video archives, summer 2014. Streaming and video archives are the important parts of those names. Now, the video archives are going back and watching videos that have been recorded from live streams. I'm not going to talk about those right now. We have another video that you can go watch that's all about watching video archives. What we're going to talk about right now is live streaming, and that's this box. The first part of this box deals with technical support. If you have problems with your audio, with your video, maybe dropout connection problems, you can contact us through our technical support page, which is here. You go to main link, you'll have a copy of this video. You can search the knowledge base, ask for yourself, or submit a request by clicking this button. There's the option for a live chat. Since most classes have a technician sitting in the WebEx stream, probably not going to be used a lot by WebEx students because they're going to have firsthand access to a technician. Remember to fill it out as completely as possible and check your email. The quicker you get back to us, the quicker we can work with you to resolve any issues. Here's all the information you're going to need to get logged in. Name of your class, the time that the class meets. Now, this is important, when the conference starts, the time zone, and how long it is. This is the link to the class, meeting number, password, and some phone numbers for folks that can't log in using computers. Let's talk about time. In this example, for a 3:40 class, 3:38 is the time that the class meeting comes up, as we call it. That's how we refer to the main teaching classroom and any other live classes all connect to the WebEx meeting at once. WebEx users are able to connect 15 minutes before this conference time. So that'll give you time to run the audio and video setup again, check your equipment, make sure that everything works, and even if you want to chat with classmates. In this example, class starts at 3:40. The video conference, the meeting, becomes active at 3:38, and you're going to be able to connect 15 minutes before that. So at 3:23, WebEx users will be able to log in and have 15 minutes before that connection time. That doesn't mean every class will begin precisely on time. That just means that whenever you see that scheduled time, you can count on between 3 and 5 minutes before is when that conference is going to come up. Before we click the WebEx meeting link, here you're going to see the meeting number and the password. These are going to be necessary for you to log into the WebEx app on your mobile device. This, joined by phone, if you're unable to log in using internet services, your webcam, your microphone, you can join by phone, but remember, that is not going to put your name on the participant list when you log in, so you may not make it on the roll unless you make special arrangements with the e-learning technician in the room. To launch the WebEx conference, click the Join WebEx Meeting link. The URL is provided separately on the next line without HTML tagging, but they're both the same link. That link takes us to the Join WebEx page. Now it's very important that you use your full first and last name as it appears on the roll, because that technician is going to be taking roll from your name on the participant list. Up here we see the green ball that says started. That indicates that the meeting is already in progress. It could be 15 minutes before the meeting and it just came up. It could be during the meeting. As long as the WebEx meeting is in existence, that will be green. And that will also turn the join button green. If you try to log in and that's any other color, if it's any other time of the day, this is going to be grayed out and you won't be able to log in. Hit join to enter the WebEx meeting. Takes a few seconds for the application to load. If you're asked if you want to install a WebEx browser plugin, approve it, and your installation should continue immediately after it's ready. Once the WebEx loads, if you've never logged in before or you haven't logged in a while, you'll be asked to choose your audio device. Audio from the meeting will be muted until this is selected. Our recommendation is using Call Using Computer for best results, but let's briefly talk about the other options. Call me. Once you're logged into the meeting, WebEx will call your phone. This is the backup method we recommend if you have trouble using Call Using Computer. The name you entered on login will be displayed on the participant list, allowing the e-learning technician to add your name to the class roll sheet, and you'll hear all the audio through your phone. I will call in. This is our least recommended option. This allows the phone to call into the conference. However, the caller's name only appears as call in and a number on the participant list, preventing the e-learning tech in class to add the caller's name to the roll sheet. You may not appear on the participant list. Let's check our settings. We're going to test our computer audio. As you can see, I have a bouncing microphone level. Let's see if the speakers are working. Sure enough, the speakers play some music for me. And that's that. It's all set. I have it set to automatically adjust the volume. That'll let WebEx decide what the best level is. And so once I've tested the audio, let's call using computer. Click anywhere else in that button. Our audio is now engaged. Now the first thing to check once that audio is engaged is this icon right here. You want to make sure that that is red. That's your mute button. That is going to prevent your audio from spilling into the conference to all the classes everywhere and all other WebEx users. So make sure that that is red. Generally, it should auto-mute when you log in, but it doesn't always do that. So you need to look at it, first of all, to make sure that you're muted. To the left of that, you're going to find a little camera icon. That's how you start your own video. We recommend that unless you have a specific need for it, don't share your video. It tends to be a little distracting. Now let's look at the WebEx app itself. To the upper right is the video window. To the left, this is the teaching computer. Tabs for the participant box. You can see it up here. There's also a button that turns it on and off. And a tab for the chat box. It's down here. And of course, that turns it on and off too. To go between the two, you click the little triangles. Participant and chat. There are a lot of components in WebEx, but in the spirit of brevity, we're not going to focus on those right now. Let's look at the video window. This is where you're going to see your instructor. You'll see the other classrooms, other WebEx meeting participants. They'll look like a shadowy outline. There's a full screen button in the upper right corner. When you expand the video window, notice the teaching computer turns off, but you can always go back by going up to the top and bringing down the ribbon and hitting return. Let's look at the full screen on the teaching computer, which is the one we recommend. You hit this two diagonal arrow icon. You blow up the content, which is primary, and that will leave the teacher up here in the corner. Now your little ribbon up at the top gives you the ability to choose your chat and participant status. So you can load up your chat, and you can load up your participants over here. Turn it back off and it returns to that small view. You can also at any time go back and revisit your audio selections. Make sure that that mute is still engaged, retest, or even disconnect altogether. You can also switch from one type of audio to another type of audio. Let's go back to our main screen. Now the chat box. Is shared by all participants in the WebEx meeting. However, it is not visible to the instructor or to the classrooms. The e-learning tech will be monitoring the text in this chat, but generally, being in a different building than the instructors, they'll most likely not be able to pass on messages directly to the instructors. You have the option to private message any participants or to talk to everyone. Generally, people communicate with the e-learning technician by private message. To ask questions or interact with the instructor, we recommend that you unmute your microphone, ask your questions in a normal voice as if addressing any class, and mute your audio again immediately when you're finished. We want to avoid any echo or feedback issues. These are the essentials of using WebEx. When you're done, you just go to File, Leave Meeting, and then confirm it. Now, back in the browser, in a few seconds, a web page is automatically going to load that will give you options on e-learning streaming media, streaming classes, and a little bit of history on e-learning streaming media. I'm Shannon from eLearning. Have a great semester.